And, should we double block this? Let's double block this. That way we avoid them giving cards. We get our 1-1. We get some lifelink from that. That's a great double block, dude. Okay, so we got this in the baggie. Get rid of that. What are we gonna sacrifice? Oh, I know. Perhaps this a roll token. Jaboom! Jabam! Hit him with the plusy wussy. I'm saying. Yo. Alright, so this is take a number like 100. I'm sorry to leave so abruptly. I am back, guys. To all of my subscribers and fans that supported me when I first started, I'm sorry to leave so suddenly. Life got insane. I couldn't afford Adobe Premiere anymore. And I wasn't even really able to be kind of like in this house, in this room. So I don't really have a good place to do it, nor the means. But I'm back, and I'm bringing a standard deck as usual. It feels so good to play Magic again. Of course, I was sort of AFK for the last, nearly two full sets. So, I mean, I did play with Carlisle Manor a little bit. But some of these newer cards from Thunder Junction are pretty brand new. I started playing with some of these this morning. I quite love the design of some of these Spree cards. So, we have Rush of the Dead in here. Cool little card. Let me show you some other ones. Insatiable Avarice, very good. I actually ended up winning a game, not on camera, with a 3 damage to the face, so that's nice. I made them draw, then they take the damage, they just lost. And then this amazing card, right? Final Showdown. So, we're doing some cool things. This is sort of your average Orzhov list. However, I do call this a hand hate deck, because it is very much a hand hate type of thing, right? We have 4 of the pets. We have 3 of the Govacans, which does, it totally hinders their sense of curve, right? We can take something that they're going to lay on like turn 3, and all of a sudden it's like a late game thing, and it's very awkward for them to lay it. So very good. We do have 3 of the No Way Outs. This is a very good card. It does create board presence as well as getting rid of 2 of their main threats in their hand, right? When you're casting this card, usually on turn 3, that's a great turn to do it, and it just messes up their whole thing, especially when you've already hit him with a bat. Say you've hit him with you couldn't have hit him with a Govacan, but you can hit him with a follow-up Govacan after that, right? Your soul searches can get you board presence and get rid of another non-land card. We have Rite of Oblivion if anything does resolve, where it's like, bop. And we can cast this twice. And we have tons of ways of easily doing that with our Hex Mage, right? This creates the cursed roll token, which we can sacrifice to then take advantage of this card. Now, this also synergizes very good with our bat, since it is a 1-1. You don't lose any of the keyword abilities, so you still have a 1-1 flying, lifelinking creature, right? Because that's sort of the downside of having a 3-2 for 1 mana is he basically has to turn himself into a 1-1, or you have to have another partner to do it. Also works very good with both halves of Crawling Chorus for very obvious reasons. So we like that. And we are using one of the new removal, Bing Bang Boom, instant card, Shoot the Sheriff. I like it. So we're checking out some new things. We have a Gonjo. A Gonjo is cracked. Now what's really good about this is if we're desperate for fodder for Rite of Oblivion, or we really need to get something out of their hand again, we really need some board presence, this can, on the second trigger, obviously do that very, very well. And then, of course, this helps us give more of a ceiling to our deck, because we can keep creating 1-1s, the Vigilance is huge, and the 3-4 body is not to be overlooked. This also helps ramp us, since we don't have much card draw or any other ramp, so very important. I think 3 copies is the magic number there. Brutal Cathar always finds its way into any deck with white for me. You know what this boy does. Plus, I have the cool art, so yeah, very good. Now, I did fit in 1-shouldered here, and 1-shouldered here sort of fit the curve. Both of these are good in their own ways. I would say the 5-mana one is really, really good in this deck, because, if anything does resolve, what kills us quickly, right? Big creatures. So this might hit that big creature and keep us alive. But this, of course, you know how good this is. Now, Wandering Emperor, premier removal spell. Now, why did I go with 3 Archangel Elspeth instead of more of the Emperor? Now, I think that this card is very overlooked. Now, it's plussing while creating board presence. Any planeswalker that plusses while creating board presence is automatically up a few pegs in my mind. And it fits really good in this deck. But you know, we don't have like a huge amount of creatures or anything. And there are the, you know, the meta is so wide now. It's hard to have a, you know, it's harder more. It's very difficult to have a grasp of things, is what I'm saying, because it's so large. There's so many more sets to consider. So this adds a sense of consistency and a sense of glue to the deck. The lifelink can be huge and keep us alive against mono red. And also that flying can help us end the game, for sure. So I quite love this. You're not gonna really minus six too much, but if you do, that's pretty good. So yeah. Geek's Command, always very good. This can be another incredible way of just blowing them out after they've sort of expend, right? We've got rid of all the things in their hand since we have so much hand hate. And say they sneak a card that gets them a bunch of little, you know, token creatures or something. Well, we wipe all those out. That's pretty devastating. We can also make one of our bigger creatures the right size. You know, even just putting the counters on the bat can be pretty annoying. You don't really want to do that. Usually you put that on like one of these Soul Search flyers or something, right? But yeah, very flexible card. Can't go wrong with a Geek's Command. And I do like having two Agonjo Seed of the Empire, so this is sort of like another removal spell in the three drop slot. And we have Takanuma to get back any of our critical pieces. As you can tell, we only have one, you know, one Brutal Cathar, one Shouldred, one of the other Shouldreds. Same with the Emperor. So if we really, really need one of those, we can get it back with this. So very cool card. And then we do run four Restless Fortresses. Since we are, you know, we do have ramp with a Gonjo. Sometimes you don't want to flood out. But if you do flood out, you can sort of justify it by using, you know, four mana for the ability, the fifth for him, and then maybe you have a sixth mana, you can cast one of the one drops. So it's not too bad to go above like the five mana slot. Et cetera, et cetera. Little life gain action. Little surveil action. Now, you know, you'd probably run four of these if you have four of these, but I only have two, so there it is. Surveilling's pretty dang good, especially if you can throw maybe a Shouldred in the graveyard, immediately bring it back with the Geek's Command, blah, 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 all that good stuff. You know how the graveyard works. So, I just want to say thank you so much to anyone that came back to the channel, like, oh yeah, this guy's still alive, and you're watching this now. You rock. I did lose, you know, a few subscribers just kind of messing around, throwing videos all over the place and just being gone for so long. So, of course I understand that, and it's very I'm inspired more than ever. So, don't forget about your boy. Let's get into some good games. We won three. I didn't put one of the games in the middle because I rage quit because I didn't understand how to cast Spree. Well, I did, but I didn't really calculate it because I had one of those Power Stone tokens incidentally from one of the opponent's cards, and I thought the Power Stone could help me out with the indestructible there, but it seemed to not. So I ended up just wiping my own creatures like an idiot, and yeah, it was very dumb. So that's not in the video, but anyway, probably didn't mean to say that. Hope you guys are having a great day, and I'll see you on the arena. All right, game one. Thank you for being here. I like the hand. We have a nice curve. We have the Spiteful Hexmage into the bat. Let me put this here. Okay, cool. And we have our one copy of our Emperor. I believe it's one copy, right? And yeah, I say let's lead with the tap land. We don't necessarily want to put the cursed roll token that comes with this guy on him. Usually goes nicely on our bat, right? Since it's already a 1/1. You don't lose any keyword ability, so you keep your lifelink and flying. So, nice little interaction there for our early game. And of course, a Gonjo is going to sort of propel us through the mid into the late game, right? Soul Search isn't bad here, being that it's mono red. They are going to. Yeah, let's actually lead with the Soul Search. So, that was a nice top deck. They don't have a one drop, which is rather sad, but we get rid of the Squee. Right? Because I was hoping we'd get that 1/1. You know, we took the chance, didn't quite pay off, but not the worst thing in the world. You know, if there was ever a deck to expect a one drop, it would be this one, right? But yeah. Laganjo gonna be clutch. If we get a mana off the top, we could actually use sorry, the Seed of the Empire as a removal spell, right? Which would be really, really good. So, let's do this, right? We lay our bat. Let's get rid of the Lightning Strike, which is nice, because that would be the removal for this fact. Let's lay this guy, and we put the thing onto the boy. Right? We didn't lose anything. We got rid of the negative aspect, and now we have a 3-2 for one mana. When this is dealt damage, he exiles the thing, so we want to definitely get rid of this instead. Definitely don't want to block it like that. Now, we are getting close. This next turn, we could lose if something very unfortunate happens. We have to go for this. We have to play to win, not play to survive. You know what I'm saying? Remember that, ladies and gents. Take anything away from the video. Play to win, not to survive. So getting to 8 here is okay. We can survive a Lightning Strike and 4 damage to mana. And they don't have it. So we got a little lucky, but that's how it'd be going. So let's get rid of this, right? Because it'll bring it back for us. Put that on that. It already has one. Actually, no, it doesn't. Yeah, it does have 2. Is that how that works? No, it only had the 1. Because, yeah, you can't only have more than 1 roll. So let's cast this. Yeah, let's lay this just in case we get one of our later game drops. Now, the Elspeth's pretty good here considering the lifelink, but no. We flash into Emperor, right? That's what we do. Nothing fancy. Nothing too crazy. Bobbity boom, bam, bang. You know what I'm saying? This is a really good card. I would not overlook this one, guys. Very good card. I actually really been liking it in today's meta, or the meta I return to after my break. Oh no! What are we going to do here? Kaboom! I think we just avoid this guy entirely. He's on the ground. We can manage him here. Okay, we got the Rite of Oblivion. So now we can see how good that is with the curse token, right? Because that's the downside of it. So, let's actually just Elspeth. Okay. We could go a little crazy, but I think we just plus. And plus. Let's actually... do we plus the bat or this? Let's be safe. Just do that. Spreading our damage, right? We don't want the bat to get removed for obvious reasons. We're in, I think we got the game, right? I can't imagine they have anything. Unless I'm unaware of something. That'll do, like, 6 to the face. There's probably those cards. I mean, gosh, I missed, like, the last 2 sets, so. I would not be surprised, dude. And, you know, again, guys, sorry for leaving so suddenly. Life got very insane. I actually had to go away against my will very abruptly. Survived what that entailed, and should we double block this? Let's double block this. That way we avoid them giving cards. We get our 1/1, we get some lifelink from that. That's a great double block, dude. Okay, so we got this in the baggie. Get rid of that. What are we gonna sacrifice? Oh, I know. Perhaps this a roll token. Jaboom! Jabam! Hit him with the plusy wussy. I'm saying. Hit him with maybe. Let's just put it all on this guy, dude. We're going big, dude. Right. Now we could like cast this again. We don't need to though. We don't need to overcommit here. And they lay burn down the house, which would wipe the whole board. That could have been a card they topped. awesome. Great. Yeah, burn that house is still legal, right? Nothing rotated, right? Anyway, alright, so let's get into some more games. Thanks for being here. Game 2, let's go. What is shaking? Alright, so game 2, let's go. We like the hand. We got the... Oh, we just got the ban at the top. I was going to say we could just lay that boy on turn 1, say screw it, and then the Agonjo could bring him back later, right? If he goes to the graveyard, things like that. But since we got the bat, changes things up, right? Go ahead. Jaboom. Jabang jaboom, you know what I'm saying? This. They will use the other one right now, probably. Oh, no, they don't. Cool. Oh, treasure token? Ooh, spicy. Except they're busting, dude, they're busting their whole load a little early, dude. Interesting. Let me see. You know, it's not like sorcery speed or anything, so that's pretty good, dude. Yeah, pretty good. Widow Bekar, dude. He's the Bekar of the Widow. Yeah, dude, let me totally block that. That's totally a smart idea. Very nice. Very nice little interaction there. However, you will not survive against my wrath. Yeah, we have to Agonjo. Playing to win, not to survive, ladies and gents. That's how best of one standard operates. No, even more so in best of one, right? For obvious reasons. Because there is a serious variable. A lot of people, you know, if you're grinding the ladder and your rank means something to you, time is a very real variable. We have limited time, so if you can get more the games in, often you'll have a higher chance of increasing your rank. So this is nice. You know, you guys know how this is working, right? Every time they cast one of these, they can untap it. They're pinging. So now we gonna do something. Now we have to do something over here. Should we rampy McRamps a lot? Will that pay off? It could. It very well could. So let's do that. Okay. When I say ramps a lot, I meant full out. Actually, I have no idea why I said ramps. Because my brain is not cooperating with my head. So let's do this. We should be able to survive this turn, right? Unless they do, like, something insane. Thunder and Raiju up the top would be kind of nice, something like that. What does Mono Red play these days? People probably laughed at it. I made someone watching this be like, Thunder and Raiju? Yeah, right. Not in this build. I mean, yeah, it's more like non-creature spell focus. Should I block this? Yeah, absolutely, man. Oh, it has a trample. That's fine. Why would you... Oh, yeah, because of the trample. See? I'm rusty. However, very good, very good. Yeah, now we're in business. Now that this guy is here, like, I'm not really scared about pretty much anything. Yeah. I mean, this doesn't really help us now. Obviously, we waited too long for our nobody else. So it's like, big chillin', big chillin'. Go ahead and do this. Okay. Let's do this. Okay. We do this. Jabam. Swing bada bada with the bat. 7 life's a lot better than 6 for some reason. I'm feeling a lot better with 7, you know what I'm saying? That made me mini snort. That was so silly, Billy. Yeah. Wait, we have a what in here? No, we don't. Yeah, we do this. Check this out, ladies and gents. You ain't ever seen anything quite like it. You just don't know. That would have been. Say they had 4 cards in their hand there, right? Pretty insane. Let's do that. Bop, 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 bop. Winning the vigilance on this, insane, because it's on block and attack you create your 1/1s. Super duper good card. I mean, this is from Kamigawa. I assume most people know this already, but don't forget about it. It exists. It's ramp. It's amazing. Okay, that's what they wanted a lot earlier. you know what it is. Oh, baby, whoa. Yeah. You're not winning that game, bro. I'm sorry. Let's do game 3 right now. Let's get a nice little quick dub to end the video. I can't even tell you. So last game, actually, it was this card, Final Showdown. I did not understand how Spree worked. I had one of those Power Stone tokens, which I thought, would allow me to cast this because it's a non-artifact thing that I'm paying for, right? The ability, but it's also part of the casting cost, so that does make sense. But so being that one mana off, really kind of threw my whole thing. I actually just ended up rage quitting. The game was definitely not over, but I was just like, man, no, dude. It was against Azorius too, so they likely had like a board wipe or something. So I was like, let's just rage quit. Let's do this now while we have the highest chance of them having a one drop. So they do. This is Audacity. It's perfect. That's what we'll click. Very good hand. Yeah, they're doing the Kallax thing. Okay. Boom, bam. Shoot the sheriff, baby. You know what I'm saying? We gonna shoot that sheriff. So what is it? It's assassins, mercenaries, pirates, rogues, and warlocks. Very weird. Very cool though. It seems dumb to slap that down, but I say we just do it, right? No, let's bomb Kallax. Let's bomb Kallax, yeah. Cause if they do lay him right now, which I assume they will. We have a huge momentum swing next turn if we get our untapped mana. Oh my gosh, what do you know? Bruh. Let me kill you. Okay. Ooh, not bad, not bad. We'll take that. We'll take the surveil. Let's keep it on top. I like it. Sure. Boom. Getting a little damage. This card is really good with our the exiling two drop that we have, the Rite of Oblivion, I believe it's called, Rites of Oblivion, and we can get things back from our graveyard, like a Donjo. We can get that card back, but he also leaves behind a body, so we're keeping that like steady flow of board presence in this deck is very important. So, and pretty much just. It's very much a mid-range deck, get rid of their sauce, keep some humble sauce on the field, and go about your day. So let's lead with this. They're not playing colors that scare me for counters. Are there green counters these days? Or white counters for that matter? Probably, who knows? Who knows anymore? Let's do this. This one drop's gonna win us the game, dude. This 1/1 flyer. Let's go, baby. Honestly, as far as token art, that might be some of the best token art I've ever seen. Look at this guy, bro. Look at this home skillet biscuit, bro. Look at that guy, dude. He's got the chain, bro. He's floating, very ethereal, chilling in the palace. The art's good. That's great art. I like the blue beige combo there of the coloration too. Yes, I will absolutely search for a card. Let's do surveil. Hey, you wanna put that on the field? Thanks. Oh yeah, dude, wait a minute. Oh, they only got two cards in hand though, so you know what, we might be able to take out a copy of this card in the deck. Do we have three or four now? I started with four, but four is way too much. Three might be too much, so who knows, but it does add to some consistency, like quite a lot. So choose a creature, destroy a creature. I don't have enough. Bang. Hit him where it hurts. You know what I'm saying? Feel bad for homie, dude. I do feel bad for homie. Let's swing with both. Check this out. Solar. So weird. Oh, they don't even do it. That's smart. That's the next level play. They're playing to win, not to survive. Goodbye. Wait, protection from vampires. Okay. It's like protection from ability from lands. awesome, dudes. Okay, so you can see I did rage quit that last game, but yeah, we're going up. Good day, Magic. I'm like definitely play some more. Trying to make two videos a day. It feels so good to have a Dolby rack, you guys. So actually, I'm not gonna go into like a conclusion thing. I just want to say sorry again for leaving so abruptly. It's not my intention. I am fully dedicated to making videos. I want to make this my life. Yeah. I'm not scared to say it. This is my dream job, dream way of contributing, I would say, as a person in the world. So, hell yeah. All the support means a lot. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. I'll see you for some more standard decks. If you're interested in other formats, let me know in the comments. If you're interested in like alchemy, historic, all that stuff, even Pauper. Pauper is something I'm very interested in, funny enough. I just think it'd be so goofy. And I started playing some other games. So if you see other videos, it's not like I'm abandoning Magic. It's just I didn't have Adobe. So I was like, you know what? Screw it. I'm going to download PlayStation 1 emulator and play Spyro. You know? Some other things just kind of tied me over. So, good to be back in the house here doing the thing. I already said that. Yeah. Peace.